Ja, ik denk dat dit mijn favoriete werk is van Christo. Dat het op zich extreem poëtisch is. Je hebt zo'n eiland, omgeven is door dikke roze lippen. En ook leuk, hier hangt een klein lapje van het originele materiaal en dat blinkt hier heel erg. Maar je moet je voorstellen wat dat in de Floridiaanse zon moet gedaan hebben. Dat moet oogverblindend geweest zijn. When I first saw your work, I was in art history class, and there were the small objects like the cans that you wrapped. Yeah. I thought that was amazing. And then all of a sudden, you blew it up to a huge scale. Where did that come from?
It's very simple, you know. From the three-dimensional work of art deal with the space, in like the painting, and the space can be very small, like a little table or a little room with the wrap table, but there's space outside of the room, very different space. The moment you walk out of your home, somebody designed the sidewalk. You cross the street, you have a red and green light, somebody designed that. Basically, for 24 hours around the clock, we're finding a highly reglemented space. And that's space we like to borrow, Jean-Claude was saying, and create gentle disturbance for a few days. Everything in the world is owned by somebody. There's not one square meter that don't belong to somebody. And we come to that space, and we negotiate it, and we're paying rent.
Nou, dit is een hele bekende. Dit heeft Christo en Jean-Claude echt op de kaart gezet. In de jaren 80 pakten ze de Pont Neuf in Parijs. How difficult is the lobbying part? For instance, Le Pont Neuf, what made them say yes?
This project was very difficult. If you have time, I'll tell you. You know, first we need to say who owns that place.
Yeah.
And basically we need to have a president of France, minister of the culture, and the mayor of Paris, and the police department again the project. And we suddenly come to the very complex thing because the president of France, Mr. Mitterrand, was socialist, and the mayor of Paris, conservative, who liked to become president, became president, Mr. Chirac, was against Mr. Mitterrand. And there was a long story. The project was refused twice, and finally we get permission.
It's allemaal schetsen voor dingen die eigenlijk nooit gebeurd zijn. Dit had in Manhattan moeten staan. Lower Manhattan had er ongeveer zo uitgezien. Het zou enorm geweest zijn. Ik denk het grootste wat hij ooit gedaan zou hebben. Maar dit zat eigenlijk nog allemaal in zijn hoofd. The projects that didn't get born, what place do they have in your heart?
Over 50 years, we realized 23 projects and we failed to get the permission for 33 projects.
Yeah.
But of course, this is part of our life.
Mm-hmm.
This is why their drawings, the study of projects never realized. But also their funny case. The Cristóbal Colón project in Barcelona was refused twice between 1975 and 1984.
Right.
And when finally we get permission in 1984, Jean-Claude and myself don't like to do it anymore. It's our idea,
yeah.
Is our excitement, if the artist or myself, mm-hmm. we lose the interest, why I should do it?
Yeah. With the Reichstag, you didn't lose interest.
No, it's three times was refusal, but we were stubborn enough, and finally we did it.
Ja, dit is natuurlijk het meest iconische werk van Christo en Jean-Claude. Niemand dacht ooit dat dit mogelijk was. Het inpakken van een volledig regeringsgebouw, van de Reichstag in Berlijn. 24 jaar zijn ze ermee bezig geweest. Moesten natuurlijk ontelbare mensen hun zegje overdoen. En wat leuk is, het is een van de enige kunstwerken waar een volledig parlement zijn goedkeuring voor moest geven. Want ja, zij konden op dat ogenblik natuurlijk niet binnen. Your work really becomes part of everyday life, and some people love it, and other people not so much. How do you deal with?
Really, I have no time to. You know, the you should understand, the work is bigger than my imagination.
Mm-hmm.
I have no time. The journalist, the writer, they can investigate it. But I'm like the work is like my baby. I enjoy to see it, to live with the work around the clock. But I have no time to go to interview people how things. This is not my job. This is not, it's your work.